Class 6, Geography, Chapter Number 1, The Earth in the Solar System. Learning Objectives. In this chapter, we will understand about celestial bodies. We will also gather knowledge about stars and constellations. Then, we have to learn about the Sun's family, that is the solar system. We will also develop an understanding about the Sun, the eight planets and the other celestial bodies, and analyze the importance of satellites and know its uses. When you look at the sky, what do you see? During the day, you see the sun. During the night, you see a vast space with the moon and numerous small points of light. Most of these appear to twinkle, and we call them stars. All these objects in the sky are called celestial bodies, also known as heavenly bodies. Let us define it properly. The sun, the moon, the planets, and all those objects shining in the night sky are called celestial bodies. The celestial bodies are spread over a very vast space. This vast space containing all the celestial bodies is called the universe. Humans have always been fascinated gazing at the night sky. Those who study the celestial bodies and their movements are called astronomers. Aryabhatta was a famous astronomer of ancient India and is regarded as the father of Indian astronomy. We understood that there are different types of celestial bodies in the universe. Here, we will learn about a few of them. Stars. You must have noticed that stars are of different sizes and brightness. These countless twinkling stars in the night sky are made up of hot gases and they give out enormous amounts of heat and light. But we do not feel their heat or light, and they look so tiny because they are very, very far from us. Stars are not uniformly distributed in the universe. They occur in groups. Millions of stars together form a group called galaxy. The Sun is a star. Our Sun is an ordinary medium-sized star. It looks bigger than the other stars because it is closer to us than any other star. Our Sun belongs to the Milky Way galaxy, also known as Akash Ganga. Constellations. Of the millions and millions of stars in the sky, some appear to be in groups forming definite patterns. These groups of stars are sometimes seen as displaying a pattern such as the shape of an animal or object. These groups are called constellations. There are 88 known constellations in the night sky. Ursa Major and Saptarishi are some of the well-known constellations. Stars help people to determine directions during the night before the invention of magnetic compass. The North Star indicates the north direction and always remains in the same position in the sky. It is also called the Pole Star. Here, you can see the picture of Ursa Major. It is also known as Big Bear. We also have the picture of Saptarishi. It is a group of seven stars. Now, we can locate the position of the pole star with the help of the Saptarishi. You will notice that if an imaginary line is drawn joining the pointer stars and extended further, it will point to the pole star. The solar system. The Sun is the central and largest body in the solar system, which consists of eight planets and their satellites and smaller astronomical objects such as asteroids and meteoroids. All planets and other bodies move around the Sun in fixed paths called orbits. The gravitational pull of the Sun keeps all the planets and other bodies in their orbits within the solar system. The word solar is derived from the Latin word sol, meaning related to the Sun. The solar system is the family of the Sun. The Sun. The Sun is in the center of the solar system. Although it is just a medium-sized star, it is huge in comparison to the other members of the solar system and is made up of extremely hot gases. It is the ultimate source of heat and light. The Sun is about 150 million kilometers away from the Earth. Planets. After the Sun, the largest celestial bodies in the solar system are the planets. There are 8 planets in our solar system. The planets move around the Sun in fixed paths called orbits. All planets have 2 motions, revolution and rotation. Revolution here means these planets are revolving around the Sun. They also rotate or spin around its axis. In order of the distances from the Sun, they are Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, and Neptune. Planets do not have heat and light. They are lit by the light of the other stars. The word planet comes from the Greek word planetai, which means wanderers. This is a fitting description of the planets, because they are constantly in motion. The planets are classified into 2, the inner planets and the outer planets. The inner planets, Mercury, Venus, Earth, and Mars, are very close to the Sun. They are made up of rocks. The outer planets such as Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, Neptune are very, very far from the Sun. They are huge planets and made up of gases and liquids. Now, we will learn about our planet Earth in a detailed manner. The Earth is a unique planet. It is the 5th largest planet and the 3rd nearest planet to the Sun. It is the only planet on which life exists. Now, let us learn about what makes Earth a unique planet. There are a number of special features which set apart Earth from the other planets. Earth is at the right distance from the Sun to get required amount of heat and light to support life. The distance of the Earth from the Sun is such that it is neither too hot nor too cold. Earth is the only planet in the solar system which supports life, as it has water and air. If you look at a photograph of the Earth taken from the space, you can notice that the Earth appears blue. The blue color is due to the presence of vast water bodies on our planet. 2/3 of the Earth's surface is covered by water. It is therefore called the blue planet. Moving on to the next topic. Satellite. A satellite or a moon is a celestial body that moves around the planets in the same way as the planets move around the Sun. All planets except Mercury and Venus have satellites. You can study the picture given here. Our Earth has only one satellite. And you can also notice that the number of moons for each planet varies. There are about 100 known satellites in the solar system. Let us define it once again. Satellites are small celestial bodies which revolve around the planets. Satellites do not have their own light. They shine by reflecting light from the Sun. There are 2 types of satellites, natural and human-made. Human-made satellites are artificial bodies designed by scientists to gather information about the universe or for communication. It is carried by a rocket and placed in the orbit around the Earth. Some of the Indian satellites in space are INSAT, EduSat, etc. A picture showing that different satellites are placed in Earth's orbit. There are different types of satellites and these are used for different purposes. Common types include Earth observation satellites, communication satellites, navigation satellites, weather satellites, and space telescopes. We will learn about the natural satellite of our planet Earth, the Moon. The Moon is the largest and the brightest thing in the night sky. The Moon looks so large because it is closer to us than any other celestial body. The Moon shines because it reflects sunlight. The Moon revolves around the Earth once in 27 days. During this period, it also rotates about its axis once. This means that its periods of rotation and revolution are the same. Because of this, we always see the same side of the Moon. The Sun always lights up one side of the Moon. But as the Moon moves around the Earth, we only see parts of this side. These are called phases of the Moon. The Moon appears as a full disk when we see the whole of the lit up side. This is called full moon or Purnima. When the part facing us does not receive sunlight, we cannot see the Moon. This is known as the new moon or Amavasya. The Moon does not have conditions favorable for life. It has neither water nor air. So, there is no life on the Moon. It has mountains, plains, and depressions on its surface. Man has always been fascinated by the Moon. During the 1960s, many spacecrafts were sent to the Moon. On 21st July 1969, man's dream of going to the Moon came true. On that day, Neil Armstrong became the first man to walk on the Moon. In this picture, you can see that between the orbits of Mars and Jupiter, there are numerous tiny bodies that move around the Sun. These bodies are called asteroids. Many astronomers believe that asteroids are fragments of a planet which exploded a long time ago. Meteoroids. Apart from the asteroids, there are small pieces of rocks that move around the Sun. They are called meteoroids. Sometimes these meteoroids come near the Earth and tend to drop upon it. During this process, due to the friction with the air, they get heated up and burn. It causes a flash of light and falls on the Earth and creates a hollow. Can you relate yourself with the universe now? See the picture given here. You are on the Earth. And the Earth is a part of the solar system. Our solar system is a part of the Milky Way galaxy, which is the part of the universe. With this, we come to the end of this chapter. Hope you all understood.